Hi everyone, welcome to this video tutorial on how to create and configure the Syncfusion React File Manager component using the Create React App command. Using the React File Manager component, you can manage the files and folders and perform other file operations like creating, editing, dragging, and dropping, and sorting files or folders. In this video, I will show you how to configure this component and a few of its features like file operations, downloading and uploading files, and showing image previews. Let's start with the application creation process. Make sure you have installed the latest version of React and Node in your system. I'll use VS Code as my editor and show the output in the Chrome browser. Now, I'll create a new application in the command prompt using the npx create react app command and provide the app name, my React app. I set the script version to template TypeScript. Then, I navigate to the desired location and install the Syncfusion File Manager package using the npm install Syncfusion ej2 React File Manager command. Next, I open the project in VS Code, and in the app.tsx page, remove the default code snippets. Open the app.css page, remove the default styles, and reference the material CSS styles to apply them to the File Manager component. To start using the component, I import it from the ej2 React File Manager package and include the File Manager component tag. Next, to render the basic layout of a file manager, I need to load the required files and folders and configure the common operations needed for managing a file system like copy, move, upload, download, edit, create, delete, and sort. To load the required files and folders and configure other operations, I should use any one of the supported file system providers to manage the files and folders either in a physical or cloud-based system. These are some of the file system providers added to the Syncfusion React File Manager. I have provided the link in the description below to learn about the other file system providers. In this example, I'm going to use the ASP.NET Core File System Provider. It provides predefined methods for loading files and folders from the specific path, performing various file operations like creating a new folder, copying, moving, deleting, uploading, and downloading the files or folders. The source of this ASP.NET Core File Provider project is available in the GitHub repo, the link for which I have shared in the description below. You can download it and reference it manually in your application as well. The documentation for the same is available in the description. Now, let's configure the file operations by adding the AJAX settings property. Here, I have planned to set the hosted server URL so that the AJAX request will be sent to the server to be processed and the response sent back. I declare a constant variable, host_URL, and assign the hosted URL link of the ASP.NET Core File Provider. Then in the URL property, set this variable and specify the server method, file operations. Now, let me show you the methods available in the File Manager controller of this project. Have a look at this file operations method first, which was assigned to the URL property. Here all the operations, like delete and copy, will be processed. Notice here, this code block will read the files and folders from the given path and load them into the File Manager component. Here we have already placed a set of files and folders in the root folder of this server project. So, the files from this path will be read and loaded into the File Manager, and then you can start performing any of the file operations. Now I'll run this application using the npm start command. Check the basic layout of File Manager. Here files and folders are loaded from the server project and has many subfolders. In the right corner, there is an input element to search for files. I can also copy and paste the file and rename it. Next, I will show you how to download a file. In the AJAX settings, I set the download URL property and assign this download method from the hosted URL link. In the download server method, we convert the JSON into an object, which will be processed using the download method. Check now, I open the subfolder, Documents, right-click any file and click the download option. The file will be downloaded to my local folder. To upload a document, include the upload URL property in the AJAX settings and assign the host URL with server method, upload. In the upload server method, we process a file or folder when uploaded. Based on the uploaded files and folders, if the directory path already exists, the files will be directly added. Otherwise, a new directory will be created using the create method, and then the files will be uploaded appropriately. Check now, I can upload a file. Notice here, when I click Pictures, Employees folder, I cannot preview the images. Next, I will show you how to preview an image in the File Manager. I include the GetImage URL property in the AJAX settings and assign the host URL with GetImage method. This method processes the content using the GetImage method. Check now, when I open the Pictures folder, you can preview all the images in its subfolders. Finally, I will show you how to display the navigation pane, toolbar, and detailed view in the File Manager layout. I just import the navigation pane, toolbar, details view, and inject from React File Manager package. Then inject these services into the component. Check now, the File Manager layout has a navigation pane and a toolbar. It also shows a detailed view of files and folders. In this video, I have shown you how to create and configure Syncfusion React File Manager component using the Create React App command and how to use a few of its features. You can download this working example from the GitHub link in the description below. I've also shared a link where you can learn about obtaining a free license key to use our React products if you're eligible for our community license. Thank you for watching this video. If you found it useful, please give it a like and subscribe to our channel.